Now, let's travel back in time to the Babylonian Empire. Not the same Babylonian Empire we spoke about when we talked about Hammurabi and his code, but a new, re-emerged Babylonian Empire under the rule of a ruthless king named Nebuchadnezzar. People of this new Babylonian Empire are referred to as the Neo-Babylonians or New Babylonians. Nebuchadnezzar oversaw the rebuilding of this new Babylonian Empire, including the canals, temples, walls, and palaces of Babylon. In fact, during his reign, the city became one of the largest and most highly regarded in the history of ancient Mesopotamia. Nebuchadnezzar surrounded Babylon with a defensive moat and a brick wall that was 85 feet thick. Nine solid gateways dedicated to important gods allowed people to pass through this wall. The most famous one today, the Ishtar Gate, was made of bricks glazed bright blue and covered in lions representing the goddess Ishtar. Take a close look at this lion here. At the center of the city, Nebuchadnezzar enlarged and decorated the city's ziggurat to the gods, and restored the temple honoring the city's chief god. Can you find the ziggurat? And finally, although the remains have not yet been found, Nebuchadnezzar may have built the famous Hanging Gardens, known as one of the seven wonders of the ancient world, near his main palace. They don't look like much today, but back then, the gardens were probably made by planting trees and flowering plants on steps of a huge ziggurat. According to the legend, Nebuchadnezzar had the gardens built to please his wife, who was homesick for the hills where she had grown up. The gardens were planted on rooftops and tall terraces so that lush greenery hung down over the walls. And if that wasn't enough, a special watering system kept the gardens fresh and green. This is why they're known as one of the great wonders of the ancient world. Imagine what it would be like to walk through those beautiful gardens. Now, let's go back to the classroom and learn more about this new but ancient city of Babylon.